Being the second smallest planet in the solar system and named after the Roman god of war, Mars is considered to be a desolate, frigid, and inhospitable rock whose colonization is one of the biggest challenges in our century. Curious to know why it is so hard to colonize Mars? Keep watching. Mars exploration and colonization have been a fantasy and a really hard challenge for humans in the current century. However, we are working to make this dream a reality, where NASA is planning to put humans on Mars by the end of 2030. One of the biggest challenges is transporting astronauts and payload across the 34 million miles of space that exists between Mars and Earth. However, upon their arrival, humans will have to face many other challenges during the course of their mission. For instance, they will have to find solutions for life-threatening problems such as the lack of water, thin atmosphere, the high levels of radiation, toxic soil, cold temperatures, and low gravity. In this video, we'll talk about each factor of these serious problems in detail. Number 1. Lack of water. As we all know, water is the most important and essential factor when it comes to the lives of humans and their survival. However, Mars does not contain water, or at least it does not contain water in a form suitable for human usage. There were signs of water on the Red Planet illustrated in some images sent by the Mariner 9 and Viking space probes back in the 1970s. Moreover, in 2018, a study was published in the science journal reporting that an approximately 12 miles in width lake had been found, and it's located about a mile below the south pole of Mars. Additionally, scientists had found 8 regions on Mars where soil erosion had uncovered huge areas of ice deposits below the Martian surface. In 2019, the American Geophysical Union reported that they located layers of ice and sand buried a mile beneath Mars's north pole. All of this information demonstrates that Mars does contain water on its surface. However, the technology required to extract this embedded water is not available to us yet. NASA is working on this problem, though, forming partnerships in order to advance their mining technologies for use in space exploration. The results of these partnerships are very promising, where in July 2019, along with the Honeybee Robotics and the University of Central Florida, NASA showed off a prototype spacecraft that is called The World Is Not Enough, or WINE for short. It is a prototype of the size of a microwave oven specifically designed to mine soil on asteroids, extract water from this soil, and then use it to generate steam in order to propel itself to its next mining destination. It's a truly promising technology, but it can be adapted to harvest water for Mars exploration. Number 2. Thin atmosphere. An atmosphere is one of the most important factors that a planet must acquire in order to support human life and survival. However, Mars's atmosphere is very thin, and it's made up of all the wrong combinations of gases. For example, it's mostly composed of carbon dioxide. Approximately 95.3% of Mars's atmosphere is carbon dioxide, which is a very high ratio compared to less than 1% on Earth. Moreover, Mars's atmosphere has barely any oxygen, around 0.13%, compared to 21% on Earth, which is very unfortunate due to the fact that humans need oxygen to breathe. In addition to this, Mars's atmosphere contains a very small ratio of nitrogen, around 2.7% compared to 78% on Earth, which is also very unfortunate due to the fact that plants need nitrogen to survive. Besides the wrong combinations of gases in Mars's atmosphere, the atmospheric pressure is unfortunately quite low, around 6.1 millibars compared to 1,013.25 millibars on Earth. In order to fully grasp this, the atmospheric pressure is crucial to the survival of humans, and without it, the trapped air pockets inside the human body would expand, the eardrums would rupture, and the water ratio in the body would boil. All of these life-threatening obstacles will face any crew members during their mission on Mars due to the extremely low pressure of its atmosphere. Therefore, in general, astronauts must wear pressurized suits to survive in space, and they will have to wear them all the time on Mars as well or even live in pressurized habitats. This will limit their freedom of moving around to collect data or samples and transporting the equipment necessary for performing their experiments specific to their mission. Having a thin atmosphere leads to many catastrophic consequences as well. For example, the Martian thin atmosphere allows the heat provided from the sun to escape into outer space, which makes the Martian nights very cold, with temperatures reaching minus 285 degrees Fahrenheit, or even below. Although numerous solutions regarding engineering an atmosphere on Mars have been proposed, none of them can possibly work, unfortunately. To elaborate, these proposed solutions suggest engineering an artificial atmosphere on Mars, which would produce the necessary gases and warm the planet. Moreover, they suggest stimulating the greenhouse gases that include carbon dioxide and water vapor, which already exist on the planet, to rise into the air and create a thick atmosphere. However, according to a study published in Nature Astronomy in 2018, Mars does not have enough of these elements on its surface in order to create such an atmosphere necessary to sustain human life. Thereby, the optimum solution is that astronauts traveling to Mars will need to bring all of the life support systems with them. Number 3. High levels of radiation. We all know that the Sun, like any other star, is a fusion reactor that emits enormous amounts of electromagnetic energy with all different types of spectrum, including X-rays, gamma rays, and ultraviolet radiation. Moreover, the Sun also emits high-energy protons, atomic nuclei, and many other subatomic particles which have significant risk on the human body. For example, it can affect the central nervous system, increase the lifetime risk for cancer, cause sickness and degenerative diseases. Fortunately, Earth's strong magnetic field forms an invisible barrier against most of the indecent radiation and diverts the electrically charged particles back into space. Additionally, the remnants of the radiation are absorbed by the thick atmosphere of our planet. Thereby, astronauts outside our protective atmosphere are at risk due to the fact that they are directly exposed to high levels of radiation. Moreover, according to the European Space Agency, ESA, the Martian thin atmosphere absorbs radiation doses up to 700 times higher than on Earth. However, the ESA agency is collaborating with some particle accelerator labs to develop new technologies that can help mitigate the exposure. In particular, they try to recreate rays of the cosmic radiation and then build shields that can protect astronauts against it. Moreover, in order to track the radiation exposure outside the Earth orbit, the ESA agency has collaborated with NASA to send radiation sensors on the upcoming Orion test launch during their mission to the Moon. Fortunately, an experiment has been conducted recently on board the International Space Station. The results of this experiment have shown that astronauts are actually able to mix cement in microgravity conditions. These results can be extended in the favor of Mars colonization. More specifically, concrete is a protective and sturdy material which is already used on Earth at nuclear facilities to help protect people from being directly exposed to the nuclear radiation. Thereby, it's possible that people colonizing Mars can use the Martian soil to make concrete that would help them construct habitable structures, which would help protect them against the high levels of radiation as well. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 4. Toxic soil. It's highly likely that the Martian soil is toxic to the living cells, which implies that we would not be able to grow food on Mars. According to scientists at the University of Edinburgh, the Martian surface is less inhabitable than we had previously thought. This means that they need to develop new methodologies in order to be able to grow food on Mars before the human colonization on Mars becomes a reality. Their findings were based on a study and an experiment conducted on a soil that contains perchlorates, which is believed to exist in the Martian soil. When perchlorates are exposed to UV light, they form a toxic cocktail of byproducts. Recall that there are high levels of radiation on Mars, and the shortwave ultraviolet radiation is one of them. And this is exactly the type of radiation used in the experiment. Moreover, there are additional chemical barriers that interact with perchlorates, which further increases the soil toxicity. Scientists believe that these chemical materials are iron oxides and hydrogen peroxide. According to Simon George, who is a professor of organic geochemistry at Macquarie University, there is no ozone layer on Mars, so UV rays penetrate down to the surface and they are very toxic. They give you a really bad sunburn if you're on the surface. But what happens is this UV radiation interacts with perchlorates and produces side products, probably chlorite and others, which are the things that are really toxic to life. Although these findings seem to be pessimistic, there's still a possibility that we will find life on Mars. But we need to search deeper, and if NASA is going to send a human mission to Mars by 2030, then they must know whether Mars is a suitable home for microbial life, and if it's going to be safe for humans. Astrobiologists are working on new methods and technologies via which there's a possibility to reach the Martian soil with enzymes in order to put the perchlorates to good use and release considerable amounts of oxygen. Number 5. Cold temperatures. Due to the fact that Mars has an extremely thin atmosphere that is around 100 times thinner than Earth's atmosphere, there's no thermal blanket that can help retain any thermal energy on the surface. The average temperatures on the Martian surface can reach about minus 60 degrees Celsius. Now, you may wonder why temperatures on Mars are cold, despite the fact that its atmosphere is mostly made up of carbon dioxide. And in order to understand the answer to this question, you need to know that there are four major factors that control the temperature of any planet's surface. These factors are atmospheric composition, atmospheric density, water content, and the distance from the sun. What makes Earth a habitable planet is the balance between these four factors, and any disturbances or changes in this balance lead to significant effects on the climate on a planetary scale. The greenhouse effect is one example of these planetary scale effects, where the gradual increase of the planet's surface temperature is because of the increased concentrations of the greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, methane, sulfur dioxide, sulfur hexafluoride, and many other gases. Surprisingly, we have raised carbon dioxide levels in our atmosphere by a very small fraction of a percent since the 1950s, and it has already been causing several changes in our climate. Moreover, water plays a crucial role in the surface temperature of any planet. It helps make heat currents move slowly, which helps retain the thermal energy inside the atmosphere. When it comes to Mars, it has a very thin atmosphere that is about 96% carbon dioxide. Moreover, it's also extremely dry because it lacks any water content and it's located further away from the sun. All of these factors cause Mars to be an extremely cold and harsh world, which would make it harder for us to colonize it one day. Number 6. Low gravity. Martian gravity is approximately 40% of that on Earth, which means that humans exposed to this partial gravity are very likely to experience muscle atrophy, which will not be a good thing, especially if they are going to stay for long periods of time on Mars. To sum it up, any crew mission on Mars will experience many harsh and life-threatening conditions, from the lack of oxygen and water, the deadly radiation, the low gravity, toxic soil, and the extremely cold surface temperatures. This means that if we really want to send a mission to the Red Planet by 2030, then we have to find solutions and develop new technologies to help make human colonization on Mars viable. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you learn anything new in this video? Do you think that we can actually colonize Mars one day? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.